So cold and flu season has begun, at least here in the Pacific Northwest, because we already are quite cold at night. And I actually work at a middle school, and there are lots of kids sick and teachers too. So I thought now would be a good time to show my homemade hand sanitizer. The reason I like to make this is because I control what goes in it. I also put it into a spray bottle, which I find more convenient than having to squeeze something out of a tube. Additionally, sometimes the ones that you can find in retail chains are extremely fragranced with very cloying fragrances that can sometimes stay on your hands for a long time. And sometimes that can bother other people around us. So what I'm going to be using in my homemade hand sanitizer is actually essential oils, so they dissipate a little bit more quickly, and they're also a bit more natural, and so it tends to not be quite as obnoxious in the scent. So to start with this, we only need about 4 ingredients. We are going to need some isopropyl alcohol. I happen to have lab grade here, which is 99%. But 91%, which you can just find on the grocery store shelf, will also work very well in this step. And this is going to be our germ killing compound. Then we are also going to need some kind of skin oil. I'm using a vitamin E skin oil from the brand Jason. This has multiple oils in it actually, besides just vitamin E. But you could use jojoba oil or rosehip oil, any kind of natural oil that you would like. And the reason behind this is it's going to counteract a little bit of the dryness that can sometimes occur when you're using an alcohol product to kill germs. The other thing that I'm going to be using is called Health Shield or Thieves Oil. Thieves Oil has been around since the times of the Black Plague, and it actually got its name because pickpockets would cover themselves in it when they were trying to practice their trade of picking people's pockets and not get sick with the Black Plague, and that's how it got its name, Thieves Oil. But basically, all that it is cinnamon oil, orange oil, and that's about it. But for some reason, it works very, very well for killing germs. So that is what I'm going to use to scent our hand sanitizer. And it is also going to assist in the germ killing properties of our product. Then you're also going to need some water, because that is going to be part of the base of our hand sanitizer. And then you're also going to need a 2-ounce spray bottle. You could use glass if you preferred, but because I send this with my children to school, I use plastic just in case it gets dropped. And once again, that's a 2-ounce spray bottle. So to begin, I'm going to put my isopropyl alcohol in first, and I want 1 tablespoon of that. So 1 tablespoon of our alcohol. Then I want about 1 teaspoon to 1.5 teaspoons of our skin oil. And once again, you can use any kind that you would like. You could use olive oil or coconut oil, whatever you like to use on your body. And I want 1 more half. So that is 1.5 teaspoons. Of our skin oil. Now I want about 20 drops of our Health Shield or Thieves Oil. Everything that I'm using will be linked down below and can be found either locally or on Amazon. So there's my 20 drops of Health Shield. Then I am going to fill the rest of our squirt bottle with purified water to the top, leaving just a bit
to put my sprayer back in. Now with this hand sanitizer, your oil and your alcohol will settle to the bottom or rise to the top. So before you spray it, every time you're going to need to shake it to give it an emulsification. So you just give it a quick shake and then you're just able to spray it. And I usually will spray it on both hands like so. Rub it together. It smells yummy, like cinnamon cookies. If you've ever had speculoos cookies or Dutch cinnamon cookies, windmill cookies, that's what it smells like. If you were ever a fan of the speculoos butter from Trader Joe's, that's exactly what it smells like. And my hands are dry to the touch, but also soft from the skin oil. And that is what I like so much about this, is that it dries quickly, but it doesn't leave your hands overly dry, and they're definitely not sticky. And as someone who does a lot with their hands, I can definitely appreciate this. I actually leave this in the door of my car so that when I come out of grocery stores and things like that, I'm able to spray my hands and the hands of my children before we go on about our business, just because this is a germy time of year. And then what I generally like to do so that you know what this is I will create a label, and you can make them, of course, fancy. I just did this one just a minute ago, just with a Sharpie and my label thing. And then you just put it on there so that everybody knows what it is. And my daughters have taken theirs to school. They just keep it in their backpack, and everybody just loves the smell of it in their classroom. So there it is, homemade hand sanitizer. Quick and easy, and you'll keep yourself germ-free this cold and flu season.